Well, good afternoon, everyone. It is Saturday, March 13th, which marks a historic milestone here in the city of Milwaukee. It was 1 year ago today that we had our first case of COVID-19 hit the city of Milwaukee. Since that time, in Milwaukee County, we know that 1,068 individuals have lost their lives and 98,620 people have gotten the disease. 1 year, 98,600 people sick, over 1,000 people have died. I think that we all recognize that this has been a tumultuous year and a very sad year in many regards because of the loss of life. But we also know it goes way, way beyond that. The loss of jobs, the people who have been impacted in their living situation, many have really suffered because of what's happened over the last year. You add on to that the fight for social justice that occurred over the summer. And without a doubt, this has been the most challenging year that we've had in the city, in the state, and in this nation. But throughout all of this turmoil, throughout all this trauma, I think it's also important to take a step back and reflect on the extraordinary efforts of Milwaukeeans who helped fight this virus on all fronts. And if there's one word that I can use to describe the people of Milwaukee, that word is resilient. Because day after day, week after week, month after month, we saw thousands of people who went above and beyond the call of duty to help others in our community. That's why throughout this week, I called on the community to share stories, photos, and tributes to individuals and organizations who have gone above and beyond in their response to this pandemic using hashtag honoring MKE heroes on social media. There are truly so many unsung heroes who have been fighting this pandemic since day one, and they all deserve the utmost praise and attention. I've been blown away by the volume of tributes from our community, and I've been sharing these stories all morning on my Facebook at Milwaukee, at Mayor Barrett, and on Twitter at Mayor of MKE. I want to highlight just a couple of the organizations today that have shared their tributes with us. And at the top of the list, without a doubt, I put our Milwaukee Health Department. The people of the Milwaukee Health Department have worked tirelessly, and I mean tirelessly, throughout the pandemic, from working with businesses on safety plans to administering COVID-19 vaccine. They've done it all. I want to shout out our Office of Violence Prevention, the Consumer Environment Health Team, and our laboratory team as well for tackling this pandemic head on. Community partners have also stepped up to make sure that everyone has the resources they need during these challenging times. Feeding America, Eastern Wisconsin's heroes are its employees, volunteers, donors, and member pantries, all making sure our neighbors at home aren't hungry by having meals to eat. Other city departments, like our Milwaukee Public Library, have served above and beyond their normal duties. Library staff have really been the utility players over the last year in city government, ranging from helping out in the election to helping out with testing. Library staff have connected patrons to online programming, hotspots, and contactless pickup of library materials. But as I said, they've also been redeployed to the health department to aid in hotline calls and contact tracing, or assisting the election commission by helping patrons vote while library branches serve as polling sites. What I plan to do is to continue to show these stories of resilience that bring us all hope as we continue to navigate the challenge of COVID-19. Milwaukee is obviously full of everyday heroes who are helping us fight the virus and keeping you safe and supported. For this, I'm grateful. And now I'd like to, if we haven't already begun it, you can see some of these that have come in. On one side of the screen, we can see the United Community Center. How can we hashtag honoring MK heroes without mentioning our UCC seniors? This pandemic hit all seniors hard, and many in-person programs had to go virtual for a long time. But we are so thankful for our UCC seniors who persevered throughout this pandemic. Thank you to the UCC seniors, and thank you to everyone at UCC for what they've done. You can see that they have continued to do everything they can throughout the past year. Let's go to the next one, if it's possible, Lexi. The Milwaukee Christian Center. It marked the one-year anniversary by honoring some heroes, including Yosef Daniel and all the volunteers and staff who worked tirelessly through our food pantry and elder meal programs to make sure our community had healthy food and basic supplies. Thank you to the Milwaukee Christian Center. Funds for Lake Michigan. We at the fund are incredibly fortunate to work with heroes every single day. And so they've been obviously working with the Riverkeeper and others to protect our waterways from pollution and contaminants. But they've continued, as you can see by these young people with their masks, to be out there cleaning our community. So we want to thank all those people who continue to go out and help our community by being involved with our environmental efforts. So to the Fund for Lake Michigan, to our Milwaukee Riverkeepers, a big shout out as well. AFT, local 12 MATC, the union over at MATC. You can see right here, Felton Benton, who's a MATC computer support specialist, has been on the campus nearly every day to ensure the students and staff have the technology needed to succeed during the COVID-19 pandemic. And I think as everybody on this Zoom call knows, we have to have people who understand the technology, and clearly they've been part of it. So again, we're honoring MKE heroes, and we're really, really pleased that we're marking this very sad anniversary with a tribute to some of our finest residents. If there's any questions, I'm happy to answer any questions. From Rose Schmidt, today also marks 1 year since the stages across the state went dark. The PAPS is taking part in the 1 year dark social media campaign. Any reflections for this industry over this past year that you'd like to share and hope for this year? Well, what I hope for this year for the PAPS and every other venue is that by the end of this year, we're going to be guns a-blazing and bands a-playing, that we want to make sure that we've got all of our venues wide open again. Obviously, we're making progress. The health department is carefully watching the indicators, and we remain optimistic that we'll be able to make some adjustments if the trends continue. But we want to see all of our venues with live music, with plays, with orchestras, with the symphony. We've got a brand new, beautiful, beautiful symphony hall, and I'd love to see that filled up. So from the neighborhood parks to the all the street parties, we want to see that all come back, without a doubt. From Ricardo Torres, as more people become vaccinated, what do I see the next step to opening the city back to where it was? Fortunately, throughout this entire year, we have committed ourselves to following the science. And I can say, as I've had people call me and ask for this dispensation or that dispensation, that every decision that we've made over the last year has been tied to public health. Every decision, I've worked with the health department to make sure that public health is first and foremost. Fortunately, what that also means is because we've set these gated criteria, and as our numbers improve, it makes me more optimistic, to the point where I'm hopeful that at the next time the health department makes its announcement, it will begin to loosen things up even more. So this week, Thursday, is the day that the announcement will come as to where we'll be. And it will be up to the health department looking at these health indicators to decide where we are. But clearly, over the last month, things have been going in the right direction. We all know that the most challenging time here in Wisconsin was in late November and throughout the month of December. But over the last month, as I've looked at the numbers, as I looked at the number of people who have become sick, the people who have died, the people who have been hospitalized, that number continues to go down. At the same time, the number of people vaccinated continues to climb. We still have some challenges in disparities in the underserved neighborhoods, and we've been working actively with the state to address those. But I think it's safe to say that we can be more optimistic now than we were 5 or 6 months ago, without a doubt. Now, having said that, we also know that we read about these new variants. We see that there's a surge going on in Europe right now. So we have to be prudent in what we do. But again, I think if we continue to follow the science, I think we're going to be in a good place. All right. Well, thank you all and enjoy this wonderful, wonderful day. Thanks, everybody.